So a lot of people ask, you know, what's better? Is it above ground shelter the way to go, or am I only going to be safe underground? An EF5 rated tornado shelter, whether it's above ground or in ground, the first thing is to make sure that the company selling it, it's been tested and verified that it'll exceed the FEMA standards. Tested at Texas Tech and verified by third party engineers that it meets what it needs to you know, be a EF5 rated tornado shelter. It all comes down to a matter of convenience. You know, in-ground storm shelters, we saw a lot of this in Oklahoma because there were a lot of in-ground storm shelters installed. They're relatively inexpensive, but they're in the backyard, so they don't get used very often. There was a story of a neighborhood, a developer developed a neighborhood, put 50 in-ground storm shelters in the ground, and there was a tornado warning, and only one family took the time to go out and use their in-ground shelter just because it was so inconvenient, and they just got so used to not using it because it was so inconvenient. But then people ask, well, maybe I'm definitely safe underground, but am I safe above ground? And so far with the, you know, most severe EF5 tornadoes, you know, with example in Joplin and Moore and Tuscaloosa, no above ground storm shelter that was built by a company who had done all their due diligence and was building a product that had been tested and verified, not one single above ground shelter failed. And that's not true with in-ground shelters because there are other variables at play other than just, you know, a shelter that's anchored and secured to a concrete slab like an above ground shelter. In-ground shelters, like we saw in Oklahoma a few years ago, some of them had actually popped out of the ground because hydrostatic pressure with the water table. Or, you know, the doors are ripped off, or there's just a lot of other variables at play whenever you're putting something in ground. The other bad thing, and something that could happen and people need to be aware of, an in-ground shelter essentially will fill with water, you know, after a tornado. So a lot of people look for an option where they maybe gonna put a shelter in the ground in their garage, you know, underneath their car, which if everything goes right, that's a good option as long as it comes from a legitimate company. But some things can go wrong. You know, I mean, after a tornado happens, a hot water tank busts. There's a lot of other things in your garage that and fluids and things that you wouldn't want basically filling into a hole that you're in, especially if you get trapped inside there. And that's an advantage of above ground shelter. I mean, obviously it's not gonna fill with water. You don't have to worry about those things. And if you get trapped, you know, you're not as worried about what's gonna happen. You just sit there and wait until somebody can get you out. One of the advantages of an Atlas Safe Room is it's modular. So the modularity literally allows you to unbolt one of the panels if the door is trapped and just walk out the side or walk out the top. You know, a lot of people are almost more afraid of being trapped than they are of the tornado in the first place. But the Atlas product gives you that peace of mind. Not only am I going to be safe if there is an EF5 tornado, but if for some reason there's a car blocking the door, then I have, you know, almost unlimited exits just by unbolting, you know, one of the other panels.